highlight of my career? That's actually an impossible one to answer, because every day is kind of like, really? I get to do that for work? So I constantly get surprised and flummoxed and exasperated and overexcited about most days at work, to be honest, but I guess that's because I love it. The most unexpected catalyst in my life started off as a negative. I was told when I was applying for jobs, first off, that I was going to need elocution lessons. I was like, no way, I'm not changing who I am. And then, weirdly, MTV UK were looking for a representation of the UK and wanted accents. So I think that's what got me the job. The hardest lesson I've learned so far is probably to not take as much notice of what people say about you, which is hard in this current age of trolls and anonymous people online. But the quicker you get over that and just ignore it, the better. I think the biggest challenge women face is be nice to each other. I think across everything, you know, and be honest with each other. We can be really nasty to each other, and I kind of wish that we wouldn't be. The reason I decided to be part of Women to Watch is because it's a positive and fun way of celebrating us. No brainer. How did I get the job I love? I got the job I love from working hard. And I think that can sometimes be the misconception that people have about TV and radio presenters, is you kind of walk into the job and when you're there, there's not much work involved. But I think to constantly strive to be good at what you do, you have to make sure you work hard.